Very good morning, guys. Class 7. Hi, how are you all doing? I hope you had a great weekend, enjoyed yourself, and had fun, and had been at home and playing, and did your studies as well. I guess on Sundays you don't study, so it's no need to tell you or force you. I don't want to force any one of you guys. So it's just that be into that pace, be into that level of studying, don't forget things, and try to improvise, become proactive, get into things, start doing them in a very proper way. You don't have to go fast, you don't have to pace up, nothing. Everything is going to be taken care of. Don't have tension, please don't worry. Everyone is thinking about children, how the schools are going to run, what's going to happen. And till nothing happens, I am here and I'm there with you. So if you have any issues, please go ahead on the school group. Please do type in something if you need anything from me. Anything. You need some counseling for yourself, you are getting troubled, you are not able to understand something, you type in a message to me, sir, please help me out with this, I need that, or whatever. If you have any issues, accept that. Well, now stay at home, listen to your parents, learn something from your mother, help your parents in doing housework, and learn something new. Listen to music, do some exercises. Well, I do it every day and I don't miss them. So it's a daily routine of your life. Your life has not changed. The only thing is that you are at home with your whole family. That's a very good thing. But at the same time, there are problems. If people don't go out to work, there is going to be an issue. And I want to say that you might hear some noises. You know, this banging of the hammer and whatnot noise, construction noise. So we have to bear with that. We have to respect each and every individual. If these guys don't work, they don't get food to eat. So laborers have been allowed to work. Contractors have been allowed to start their building material construction work. So these guys are working. So I respect them. So just let this noise go into your right ear and take it out from the left ear. Just keep my sharing information inside your head. Don't let it go out from the left hand side. Okay. Guys, okay, so now we were at monuments, numismatics and sculptures and paintings and oral traditions. This information I've given you in the last video. I've given you a PDF, I've given you all information, I've given you notes. Now I want to tell you guys one thing. You will not copy what I'm giving you. Understood? You are not going to copy the information which I'm giving you in the download tab. You have to read through that, understand it. See, you're going to compare it with my video if I have said anything wrong or it's going to match with that or not. Then you jot down your own information, what you learned from that in your language. It will stay inside your head lifelong. And then you try to memorize it or try to understand. If you understand the thing, you don't have to memorize it. It's already inside your brain. Do you memorize your birthday every year? Oh, my birthday is on this date. Oh, June, July. Do you do that? No. That's already inside your head. That means you know about your birthday. So get interested in history also. History is a damn good subject, guys. You have to just go into it. You have to start looking, finding, try to learn more. And I'm there to help you out. Please don't take stress. Don't get tensed. Everything will go with the flow. You just relax and do your studies. Be in touch with it. I'm solving you answers. I'm giving you PDFs. I'm giving you notes. All are helpful to you. I'm giving you various type of notes so that you can match and compare and make one. Answer is going to be same. If they ask about what are numismatics, answer is going to be same. The collection of coins, but you can write it in different ways. Isn't it? Just like that. Oral traditions. How do you get information from oral traditions? You get from poets, you get from lyrics, we get from songs, we get from plays. Then there are various types to write about it. Okay? And do it that way. And handwriting page every day, I need one page. And guys, I'm going to catch you when the school opens. So make sure you do your writings, learn your spellings, take out word meanings, try to learn out word meanings, the one which are difficult, go into the dictionary, avoid going to Google. Okay? Don't use the net too much. And because you're already playing your Free Fire and all that stuff, so don't waste your time on the net again. So go into the dictionary where you can read. Google is going to give you the instant information, but you have to look and find, and then you learn to know about the dictionary as well. Okay, guys. So be good, and let's start the next chapter. I've given you question answers for this also already. For this, what, how, and when I've given you this. Sorry, what, where, when, and how. Information about how things changed, how things happened. Okay. So you can get that. We get information from the archaeological information, then we get information from the accounts of travelers, regional literature, religious literature, calligraphy, all that. So you can jot it down. If you have any issues regarding this first chapter, please do go ahead and drop a message. Okay, I'll get back to you and solve the issues which you have. If you're not able to understand any part, just jot down that part. I'm not able to understand this part, sir, please help me. I'll go ahead and do that for you. Okay, so now let's go to the next chapter. I guess that's about regional kingdoms. Okay, the early regional kingdoms, right? Okay, so we are going to do that. Now, what were the kingdoms involved? We are going to do that. So the new kingdoms, what region they were in, like what time this was all about. So I'll just read a few little part, and we'll get to know what's happening. Okay, so we'll do it that way, and we'll come to know what's happening during this regional issues. Okay, so okay, the Rajputs, we have the Rajputs region here. Okay, there was some problem, I guess, with the video. We have the new kingdoms here, as we had read about in class 6 about Harshavardhana in Kanauj, who had set up a large empire and ruled for about 4 decades. And after his death, his empire went down. The northern India broke into smaller kingdoms. Many of these kingdoms were ruled by clans known as Rajaputras or Rajputs. Apart from the Rajput kingdom, the Chola kingdom deep in the south was also very powerful. So we are going to read about the Rajputs and the kingdoms in the south right now. After that, when we go ahead, we'll go into the Delhi Sultanate. Okay, so we'll reach there. So I'll come back in the next video and I'll explain this properly. Okay.